Today we learn about motions of the earth. We know as a planet the earth is moving around the sun. We know that it has two types of motion. They are rotation and revolution. Let us come to rotation first. Rotation of the earth is when the earth is rotating in its own axis in 24 hours. In one day, we call it as one day. The movement of the sun around the earth in a particular path is called as revolution. So when earth is rotating in its axis, we call it rotation, which takes 24 hours. When earth is revolving around the sun in a particular path, which we call as its orbit, we call it as revolution. The axis of the earth, we know that the earth is not straight, it is a little tilted. The axis of the earth is 66.5 degrees. It is tilted at 66.5 degrees. And we have an imaginary line joining North Pole and South Pole, which we call as axis. So on this axis of the earth is rotating once in 24 hours time. That is known as rotation. Why we need it, this rotation? We need it. The reasons we need rotation and what will happen if the rotation is not there, we will discuss now. Now the circle is divide the day and night. What, due to rotation, what we get? We get day and night. So in 24 hours, we are getting day and night due to reason is rotation. And this day and night, it has a line. We can experience it at the time of dusk or dawn. This is known as illumination line. This line of illumination, the circle of illumination, we call it. After that, either earth is entering in this lightened area, that is day, or it is entering to the night. We call it as dawn in the morning and dusk the evening. What happens if the earth is not rotating? If it just stops rotating, what will happen? One side of the earth only will be facing sun. As a result, the one side of the earth will be too hot, the opposite side of the earth will be too cold. Can we survive there in this condition? Both the way it will be severe condition. No, life cannot exist there. We cannot survive. We will have continuous 24 hours day. At the other side, we will have continuous 24 hours night. One side will be continuous light and the side will be continuous dark. So in this position, we cannot survive. We cannot live. Next, we are coming to revolution. So we need rotation for our survival. We need, due to rotation, life is possible on earth. Coming to the revolution, the second motion, that is the another major motion of earth, that is revolution. Earth is revolving in its orbit. Remember the first chapter we have learned about. In its orbit, the earth is revolving around the sun. It is not only earth, all the planets, they have their revolution. So revolution, earth is revolving around the sun in a particular orbit. The time is taking 365.25 days. Now what happened to this 1/4 days? These 365 days we have considered as 1 year. So every day in a year we have 365 days. What we are doing with this 1/4 days? These 1/4 days is accumulating for 4 years. For 4 years, every year we are, earth is saving 1/4 days, earth day. And bees are accumulating, getting one day extra in one year. After 4 years, we are getting one day extra. We are adding that extra day in the month of February, and we call this year as a leap year. Now, can you calculate which year is a leap year? I am giving the easiest way to calculate a leap year. Any year, if you can divide it by 4, it will be a leap year. Take example of 2000. Can we divide it by 4? Yes, we can. So, 2000 will be a leap year. Another example, if we say 2013, is it a leap year? As we cannot divide this by 4, it will not be a leap year. Now calculate, this year will be a leap year or not. 2016 is divisible by 4. So, it is a leap year. You know now what is a leap year. Next, we are coming about the season. Now, as here we have seen that rotation caused day and night, and we need it because otherwise in the extreme condition we cannot survive. The same way, why we need revolution? What happened if earth is fixed in one position and it is not revolving? Even in that case also life will not be possible, because even it will be an extreme condition where life cannot survive. Revolution mostly cause season change on earth. Now we will discuss about the seasons. Revolution is caused season change. We will discuss now throughout the world why we are getting different season in a particular time. Let us discuss what is the result of revolution now. We can see in this diagram the earth is revolving around the sun. We have taken 4 position of earth around the sun. Let us start with 22nd December, that position. If we can say, we are giving few names like A, let us take it as B, let us take it as C, and this one as D. Now, earth is in this position. What will happen? This is North Pole. We know this is the earth. This is the axis of the earth, North Pole, and this is South Pole. We know all this thing. Now, earth is, if we can draw the equator also, it is better. This is equator. Now, earth is getting light from sun. Earth has no, we know that earth has no light, no heat. It is getting it from the sun. So, which part of the earth, which hemisphere now is getting direct sun rays? We can see that it is the southern part, the southern pole. Southern pole is nearby to the sun, whereas the northern pole is far away. So, this is the time, 22nd December, when northern pole, northern hemisphere is getting less sun rays and heat from sun. Or at the same time, the southern part, the southern hemisphere of earth is getting direct sun rays. This is the time when direct sun rays falls on this 23.5 degrees south, that is Tropic of Capricorn. Direct sun rays falls on 23.5 degrees south, that is Tropic of Capricorn. This time we call as, based on this northern side, with northern hemisphere winter, we call is as winter solstice. Now, can you answer me that why Santa Claus at the time of 25th December, if he is visiting New Zealand, which is in northern, in southern hemisphere, why he has to, he needs to remove his winter clothes and all? Because the southern hemisphere is getting its Christmas time when we all have winter, they have their summer. So, both the hemispheres, their seasons are different. Northern hemisphere, 22nd December, it is winter. It is winter in north, but it is summer in south. What is the why it is like this? Because the 23 and half degree south latitude is getting direct sunrise, and the south pole, we can see as the earth is tilted, the south pole is getting, the southern part is getting direct maximum sunrise. Days are long now in the southern hemisphere, days are short in northern hemisphere at the time of 22nd December. So we call it as winter solstice. In northern side, northern hemisphere, they faced the smallest day and biggest night in 22nd December. Just the opposite in southern hemisphere, where they face the longest day and shortest night in this time. This is one position we have taken. Now let the earth move to the second position, that is position B. After 22nd December, it is coming to 21st March. Earth is revolving. It is going from this position to this position. What we can see now, this is the north and this is the south. This is equator. Now, this is the time when sun rays are falling directly to equator. Sun rays are direct on equator. As a result, everywhere, both the hemisphere in the world, they are getting equal sun rays and heat. And the earth is the heat and the light equally distributed. The entire earth is getting same amount of heat and light. This is the day, 21st March, when day and night is same everywhere in the earth, and we call it as equinox. Again, we are naming it based on the northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere, after winter we may experience spring. So 21st March is called as spring equinox. Next, we are coming to June. Again, earth started moving and it came to the direction, it came to the position of this here. Again, we are drawing equator and we are drawing Tropic of Cancer also. We are drawing equator and we are drawing Tropic of Cancer because this is the time when Tropic of Cancer is getting direct sun rays. What we can see, the northern part and northern pole, the northern hemisphere, that is facing the sun, and the southern hemisphere is a little far away from sun. So in 21st June, northern hemisphere is facing summer, experiencing summer, and the southern hemisphere is experiencing winter. When we have summer, as India is in northern hemisphere, when in India we have summer, the countries, those who are located in southern hemisphere, they will be experiencing winter. So even in 21st June, in the summer season, if you feel like you will be visiting any country which is located in the southern hemisphere, you have to carry your woolen clothes, because those parts, they will experience winter season then. In northern, again depending on northern hemisphere, we named it as summer solstice, and this is the day when northern hemisphere, 21st June is the day northern hemisphere is experiencing the longest day and shortest night. Opposite way, in the southern hemisphere, they experience the shortest day and longest night. It is summer in north and it is summer in north, and it is winter in the south. Again, earth started moving. It will be revolving in its orbit and it will reach the position, that is 23rd September. 23rd September, again as it was in 21st March, it is the sun rays is directly, it is falling on equator, 0 degree. What will happen if the sun ray is falling directly on equator? The entire places, countries, whatever we have on earth, they will be getting same heat and same light. And that's the reason the entire countries in on the earth, they will be experiencing half day and half light, the same amount of daytime, day and night will be equal in everywhere in the earth. This is also known as an equinox, and based on the northern part, northern hemisphere, based on the northern hemisphere, as after summer we experience autumn, we call is as autumn equinox. These are the major four seasons we can find on earth. Let us repeat once more. Sun is the source of all heat and energy, and as earth is revolving, it is giving the amount of heat and energy. It is controlling the daytime also, and that causes the season change. Now in the 22nd December, as the northern pole is away from the sun and the southern pole is facing the sun, we can see that northern pole has winter and summer, southern pole has summer. At the same way, it will be known as winter solstice, and it will be for northern hemisphere, it will be the shortest day, longest night. For the southern hemisphere, it will be the just the opposite, longest day and shortest night. Revolving to the 21st March position, we will find that sun is giving direct sun ray to the equator. So every places on the earth will be getting same amount of heat and light. So it will be known as equinox. We call it as summer equinox, spring equinox. We call it as spring equinox, and here day and night will be equal for everyone in the world. Coming to the next position, position C, that is 21st June, when we can see the northern side is facing the sun and southern hemisphere is a little far away from the sun. So, and this is the time when 23.5 degree north, that is Tropic of Cancer, is getting direct sun rays from the sun. As a result, northern hemisphere is experiencing summer, southern hemisphere is experiencing winter. Based on that, we name it at summer solstice. This is the longest day and shortest night in northern hemisphere and shortest day and longest night in the southern hemisphere. Next is, the next part is 23rd September, when sun rays falls on equator directly, dividing the heat equally throughout the world, heat and light, and we call is at autumn equinox. Day and night is equal everywhere in the world on this day, at this point of time. This is actually the season, and how Earth's revolution is causing the season is discussed in front of you. Now think about this, that if Earth is just fixed in this position, no revolution, what will happen? If Earth is just fixed in this position, then northern hemisphere will be experiencing winter throughout the year. At the same time, the southern hemisphere will be experiencing summer throughout the year. As a result, again, the northern hemisphere will be too cold and southern hemisphere will be too hot. Life will not be possible at the same way. Now, another thing you can see here, that the southern hemisphere, this is the entire time it is getting sun rays, whereas the northern hemisphere, for this time, this half, if we are dividing it into half, we can see half of the year The northern hemisphere is getting sunlight, facing to the sun. The half of the year we can see the southern hemisphere is facing to the sun. This is the reason we can see that 6 months day in the poles, pole regions, 6 months day and 6 months night. So this is the time for 6 months day in southern pole and north 6 months night time. Same way here. For the north pole, this is 6 months daytime, and for south pole, this is 6 months night time. Let us discuss once more what is the angle of inclination we have learned in this chapter. We have learned that the Earth's orbit, the axis, it is inclined 66.5 degrees. And then we learned about rotation and revolution. Rotation is when Earth is rotating in its own orbit. It is rotating its own orbit, that is known as rotation. And when it is revolving in around the entire, it is revolving in its orbit, it is known as revolution. Rotation in its axis, revolution in its orbit. Now, the third part what we have learned, that rotation causes day and night, revolution causes season change. What is a leap year? Every leap after every revolution, Earth is accumulating 1/4 daytime. That in 4 years we can say that is accumulating, and we are getting one full day, that is adding in the year, that is adding as a year, as a day in a year. And that year is known as a leap year. Which month we are adding the day? We are adding that day in the February month, and we call it as a leap year. I told you how to calculate it also. You just can divide by 4. Any year, divide by 4, you will get whether it is a leap year or not. Next, we learnt about the season change. How the season changes caused, that we learnt here. We learnt about the summer solstice, we are learnt about the winter solstice and the equinox. When sun rays are on the tropics, we call this as solstice. When sun rays are directly on the equator, we call this as equinox. We have two solstices, that is summer solstice and winter solstice. We have two equinoxes, that is spring, autumn equinox and spring equinox. That's all for this chapter. Hope you have enjoyed it.